occasion on 26th November 1949 and the constitution has been adopted, which will be implemented on 26th January 1950. So 26th January 1950 is a first Republic Day, and 26th November 1949 was the first Constitution Day. Constitution was adopted by the Assembly. So today we are going to read together the preamble to the Constitution. The preamble explains the objective of the Constitution, why the Constitution has been drafted and why we have adopted for that. What is the objective of the Constitution? Preamble will explain. Also, we are going to read the fundamental duties which have been enshrined in the Constitution. We are very often talking about fundamental rights. We talk about rights, but Constitution also speaks about fundamental duties. You know, India is blessed with 130 crore people. If all 130 crore people talk only about fundamental rights, how the rights will be translated? It's the same coin. If you have a coin, look on both sides. We call it as a tail of the side, tail side and head side. So both should be there for a coin. Similarly, your fundamental rights should also have fundamental duty. So all 130 crore population have blessed with fundamental rights and obligated with fundamental duties. And therefore, this year, for the Constitution Day, Government of India decided that fundamental duties should be inculcated in the minds of all citizenry, especially the youngsters, students, teachers, parents, and all young generation about the importance of fundamental duties. And that is why today we have gathered here on the occasion of Constitution Day to jointly read the fundamental duties in the presence of Honorable Lieutenant Governor. She being a constitutional authority appointed by Honorable President in exercise of powers under Constitution, so it is apt that this joint reading is done in the presence of a constitutional person. So I once again welcome you all for this beautiful evening, and let us read it and also decide and take a pledge that we will pursue, follow, and also see that these duties are carried out as written by our forefathers in the Constitution. Thank you very much.
We have a small intertalk by the student. I kindly welcome Darish from our VAOC school. Request the audience to give him a good clap and encourage him.
கள்ளை புசைந்து கனியாக்கும் சுந்தமிழுக்கெண் முதற்கண் வணக்கம். மற்றும் இங்குள்ள அனைவருக்கும் என் பணிவான வணக்கம். மதிப்பிற்குரிய கவர்னர் அவர்களுக்கும் என் பணிவான வணக்கம். நான் இப்பொழுது இந்திய அரசியல் அமைப்பு சட்டம் எனும் தலைப்புள் என்னுடைய கருத்துக்களை உங்கள் முன் கூற விழைகிறேன். இந்திய அரசியல் நிர்ணய சபை இந்திய அரசியல் சட்டத்தை உருவாக்கும் பணியில் இறங்கியது. அதற்காக அமைத்த குழுவில் அம்பேத்கரை அதற்கு தலைவராக நியமித்தது. தாழ்த்தப்பட்டவர் எனும் காரணத்தை கூறி பல இன்னல்களுக்கும் அவமானங்களுக்கும் ஆளாகி அண்ணல் அம்பேத்கர் அரசியல் அமைப்பு அரசியல் சட்டத்தை வகுக்கும் குழுவிற்கு தலைவராக தேர்ந்தெடுக்கப்பட்டது பெருமைக்கும் பாராட்டிற்கும் உரியதாகும். சட்ட வல்லுநர்களான சர் அல்லாடி கிருஷ்ணசாமி, சர் பி என் ராவ், ஸ்ரீ சையத், சர் கிருஷ்ணசாமி, சர் முன்ஷி எம் முன்ஷி ஆகியோரும் அரசியல் சட்ட அமைப்பின் குழுவில் அம்பேத்கருக்கு உதவியாளர்களாய் இருந்தனர். சில மாதங்களில் சர் பி எல் மிட்டருக்கு பதிலாக மாதவராவ் தேர்ந்தெடுக்கப்பட்டார். இது தவிர தீபிகேதான் திடீரென மரணம் அடைந்ததால் அவருக்கு பதிலாக தமிழகத்திலிருந்து டி டி கிருஷ்ணமாச்சாரி நியமிக்கப்பட்டார். இந்தியா சுதந்திரம் பெற்ற மகிழ்ச்சி ஒரு பக்கம் இருக்க, ஆறு மாதத்தில் அவருடைய அரசியல் அமைப்பு சட்டம் முடிவடைந்தது. நாட்டில் முதன்முதலில் எழுத்துறவில் உருவான சட்ட வடிவமைப்பு இதுவே ஆகும். 1948 கிருஷ்ணமாச்சாரி நடைபெற்ற பொதுக்கூட்டத்தில் பேசிய போது அம்பேத்கரின் அளவற்ற சட்ட அறிவினை கண்டு வியந்தார். அரசியல் நிர்ணய சபை நான் அரசியல் நிர்ணய சபைக்கு வந்தது தாழ்த்தப்பட்ட மக்களுக்கு சேவை புரியவே. அரசியல் நிர்ணய சபை என் அரசியல் சட்டசபையில் எனக்கு இடம் வழங்கியது எனக்கு ஆச்சரியத்தை தந்தது. அதன் தலைவராக நான் தேர்வு செய்யப்பட்டது இன்னும் என்னை வியக்க வைக்கிறது. நாட்டுக்கு சேவை செய்ய எனக்கு இந்த சந்தர்ப்பம் வழங்கிய அரசியல் நிர்ணய சபைக்கு நான் நன்றி தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன் என்று கூறினார் அம்பேத்கர். இறுதியாக, அனைவரும் அரசியல் அமைப்பின்படி செயற்படுவோம் என்று கூறி விடைபெறுகிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
We request, we have a visitor from Tirupati Edifi School, Ms. Lekhya on the dais, please.
A very good morning to our Honorable Dr. Kiran Bedi, ma'am, the Lieutenant Governor of Pondicherry, the dignitaries here and all the great gathering here. So I'm here from Edifi School to speak a few words on this occasion of National Constitution Day. National Constitution Day is celebrated to mark the adoption of a constitution. The Constitution of India was drafted on 26th of November 1949 after almost 3 years of rigorous hard work by a drafting committee headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The Constitution came into effect on 26 January 1950, which is celebrated as the Republic Day of India. National Constitution Day is celebrated on 26 November each year since 2015. The Constitution of India comprises of 448 articles, 5 appendices, 12 schedules, and 25 parts. The Constitution was signed by 284 members of the Constituent Assembly on 24 January 1950. Indian Constitution has undergone 101 amendments since its inception. As Dr. B.R. Ambedkar rightly said, law and order are the medicines for the body politic, and when the body politic gets sick, the medicines are to be administered. Our Constitution has also faced some challenges, like difference between the interpretation of Constitution by government and judiciary, balance between fundamental rights and directive principles, stability of government, relations between center and states, and internal emergency. Constitution framed by our founding fathers is an achievement in itself, and the biggest evidence is existence of Constitution till now. Many people believed a diverse democratic country like India couldn't stand this democracy for a long time. We proved them wrong, but we have to follow Constitution both in letters and spirit. The Constitution of India is the longest written constitution of any other sovereign country in the world as of 2019. I'm delighted to get this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Lekhya. We come to the main part of the program today, and I request Additional Secretary to Lieutenant Governor, sir, could we have you on dais to read out the preamble, and we could follow. The words would come on the screen. Please repeat. Thank you, sir.
We the people of India,
we the people of India,
having solemnly resolved to,
constitute
India into a
sovereign socialist,
secular democratic republic,
and to secure
to all its citizens,
justice,
social, economic, and political,
liberty of thought,
expression,
belief, faith, and worship,
equality of status,
and of opportunity,
and to promote,
among them all,
fraternity,
assuring the dignity
of the individual.
So that the nation
constantly rises to higher levels of endeavor,
constantly rises to higher levels
the right to education became a fundamental right. Earlier it was 6 to 14 years of child, but this was, and so then this was added for including early childhood also, and for 6 to 14 years. Because the Right to Education Act came once by 86th Amendment, Right to Education became a fundamental right. So this was the 11th right which was added by 86th Amendment, so which is what mainly the parents and guardians. Who is a parent or guardian?
Who is a parent or guardian?
Provide opportunities for the education to his child. Or as the case may be, born.
Or as the case may be, born.
Between the age of 6 and 14 years.
Between the age of 6 and 14 years.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, children, and thank you, teachers, for coming. It's a very important day, and I'm very grateful to the leadership in Government of India, which has made us celebrate Constitution Day like this. And that also focusing on our duties. You've all read the duties. We've always been insisting, and as Mr. Nitidar said, always been insisting on my right, my right, my right. But we don't say my duty, my duty, and my duty. If we start saying my duty, then I'm protecting everybody's rights. But if I say only my rights, then I'm fighting, I'm asserting, but I'm also fighting. But if I'm not doing my duty, I'm sharing, and I'm giving, and I'm being respectful to the others. Now, I have a few questions to ask you, you will answer. We, the multitasking staff of Public Works Department, multitasking staff stands in the filth, dirty water in the drains and cleans it regularly. And in the end, we spend a lot of money cleaning it. That is our right to have a clean drain. It's our right. What is our duty? What is our duty? Say, what is our duty? Who dirties it? How do we dirty it? How do we dirty it? What makes it go dirty? Stand up and speak.
We dump the waste in the water bottle.
We dump the waste in the water bottle. Our multitasking staff falls ill. You can't even touch that water. And our staff, there are brothers and sisters. There are people. They stand in the filth and clean it every day. And yet what happens? Our shopkeepers, our residents, and we as citizens, what do we do? What do we do? I've seen mattresses out of drains. Mattresses. I've seen carpets in the drains. Carpets. I've seen tree logs in the drain. People just throw it there. So what is our duty? So if we all do our duty, we don't throw this, we don't throw plastic there, we don't throw waste there. If we do not throw this in the drain, what will happen? Whose right will be recognized? Will we get our right? Yes, we will have our right. Right of clean drain. Isn't it? So what is lesson learned? Lesson learned is, if we all do our duties, drains will be clean. Yes, but if we only looking for right for MTS to do its duty, right for PWD to do its duty, rather than you are asking them your right, you are asserting your right, asking them do your duty, they are very, PWD doesn't do its duty, they don't do, they are not absent, but who's dirtying it? We. So we are asking for a right, for a clean drain. But we are not fulfilling our responsibility to keep it clean. Have you understood? Okay. Now, you all want to walk the road safely? Yes? Who makes it unsafe? Your right to safety on the road. Who makes it unsafe? Who? Who?
We.
How? How? How do we make it unsafe? By walking zigzag on the road. Yes? your right to walk on the road. You have a right to walk on the road. But they have a right to walk here also, and walk there also, and walk there also. They'll have to see whether there's a car or not. Should we not see? Should we not walk on the side? And if there's no footpath, we walk on the side. But rather than going over road, this way also, having also, and fraction also. We zigzag around. Secondly, we sometimes drink. We have a right to drink. No, you don't have a right to drink. You don't have a right to drink. No right to drink. We have a right to drink clean water. But how many of our fathers have a right to drink? Many fathers have a right to drink every day, but no duty to pay the fees of the child. That fee is paid by government to Puducherry. So right to drink, yes, that is a right to drink. And many of our fathers every day exercise their right to drink. What is their duty? To contribute to the household. Their salaries should be contributed to the household. Contributed to the child's welfare. Health of the child, fruits, milk. When I fruits in the house, many children who came here one day were eating banana for the first time. When we had a function recently here, we gave a banana to everybody. Many children kept it. I don't like it. I don't drink it. I don't take it. They never eaten a banana in their life. It's not that they didn't like it. Nobody told them the value of banana. It's a cheap fruit, but full of iron. It's a food by itself. It's cheap, but it's good. So whose duty is it? The father who exercises the right to drink. Or we drink and drive. We drink and then we drive. Youngsters, scooters. So whose duty? What is the duty? The right to safe road, but I'm driving, I'm walking carefully, but here comes a youngster, no helmet, and drives over the person. You have violated somebody's right. So you are exercising your right to drive, but you're violating somebody else's duty to safe road. You understand that? So that is what we have, only I have a right to drive, but I don't have a duty to be safe. The day we start thinking of every time my right, not right to clean water, but my duty not to waste water. When I have drinking water, thank God you got drinking water today. And it costs a lot of money to have clean drinking water. But I waste it. I throw it. I have a glass of water, I drink only half and leave the waste. Why? Drink the whole thing. It's good. Why waste it? It's my duty not to waste. This is the message today of rights and duties. Every time you do something, you feel it's your right. Right to, for instance, you have a right to have female friends. All boys and girls should be friends. But is it your, why do women get teased? Who is violating their rights? When women complain of crimes against women, who is violating the rights of women? Who? Who? Boys, girls are teasing girls? Girls are teasing girls? Are girls teasing girls? Yes or no? Who's teasing the girls? Who is? Is it your right to tease the girls? Is it the right of the boys to tease the girls? And isn't there girls' right for safety on the road? So, you have a right to be friends, but you have no right to tease another safety or disturb another safety or disturb another person's space. Have you understood? If this is a message going from schools and principals and parents, India would be a great country. 1.3 billion people exercising duties, city would be clean. You want a tree. But how many of you plant a tree on your birthday? Raise your hands. How many of you plant a tree on your birthday? Isn't it your duty to celebrate your birthday by planting a tree? It's your duty. You want a tree, but you don't plant a tree. Yes? How many of you plant plant a tree on your parents' birthday. You can plant a tree on your anniversaries, remembering your grandmother. You can plant a tree in their name. Oh, no, no, but I have no tree. I have no plant. Maybe the government has not given me a plant. Isn't it your duty? Go, get a plant. Don't you spend money on anything? Go, buy a plant. Find a space. Go and plant a tree. Get a palm tree, a palm seed. Go plant a seed on the lake, on the side of the lake. It will one day come. You don't have to wait. If 1.3 billion people plant one tree, even in a year, India will have 1.3 billion trees. Imagine just one. On your birth, everybody has a birthday. Everybody has parents' birthday. Everybody has anniversaries. Plant trees on that day. Celebrate. And your marriage. All of us on the marriage, plant a tree. Isn't it our duty? But you have a right to the fruit of a tree, but no duty to plant a fruit tree. So if we remember these things, everything you do, if you remember, this is my right, I'm enjoying it, what's my duty? And if you start exercising, now let this session be not limited to these 100 plus. Go and pass on this to 1:10. School assemblies, friends, people, take a session. Say, sit down, I will tell you what I've learned today. Sit down, I will tell you. I will do this. You resolve to do the following. You say, as a group, we will do this. Get into activism. Girls can do, boys can do, teachers can do, school assemblies can do. It can be wonderful. For this country, the day everybody starts observing their rights, their duties, rights will be protected. We want a bus. I want a free bus. But when I'm angry, I burn the bus. It's my right to burn. But your right is saying you will protect property. Why should you burn your own property? Will you burn your own house? Why do you burn public property? That school bus is safe for you. Now you say, I have a right for another bus. But now there's no bus. You burnt it. No, no. Then you agitate again. I want a bus. But you burnt it. And then you say, government failed, it did not give me a bus. So friends, I just wanted to sensitize you. Why are we celebrating fundamental rights and duties today? Is because we were only taught Human Rights Commission. Why should it not be Human Duties and Rights Commission? If you start talking about Human Duties and Rights Commission, rights will be protected. But if you don't talk about duties, only of the rights, as Mr. Nidhi Das said, then you are only one side of the coin. And any side of the coin where this doesn't have a second coin, the coin does not work. In my language of Punjabi, it's called Khota Sika. Means it's what? Rotten Sika. Rotten coin. It doesn't have any value. Right without that, a coin without the head and the tail, that coin has no value. The shopkeeper will say, take it back. It doesn't, it's fraud. A good human being is two sides of the same coin. Exercises rights when it's need to exercise your rights. You must exercise your rights, but in a manner which is responsible. Sense of responsibility as a citizen. I thank you for listening to me. I've enjoyed interacting with you because this is an area which we take for granted and we don't talk and express so much with the people and so much with the youth. But I hope that this 100 will multiply into 1,000 today. Go and tell your friends on the road, in the school or college, at home, in the society, in the community, in your festivals. Start adding the concept of duties, concept of responsibilities. Thank you. Jai. So when we go cycling, will you like to join us?
Yes, ma'am.
You like cycling?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have a cycle?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we'll send a message to you then. And will you come at 7 o'clock at Raj Nivas? 7 in the morning?
Early morning.
Oh, now they want to go. Now you're wondering. We go 7 in the morning, Saturdays and Sundays.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Now they change the mic. Let me see how many come. Let's see what we do this Saturday, Sunday. We'll send you an invite. You come to Raj Nivas and bike with us if you're going biking. We go to Valrampet Lake, we go to Kanagan Lake, and we go to other places. Want to come?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
But they were half yes. Okay, good. So we'll send you a message through your teachers and you can join us. It's an optional thing if you feel like coming. But if you come, it's a wonderful thing. Then you'll see your town yourself. Is it clean? Is it safe? And so many things.
Shubha Naame